The ECZ also undertook publicity activities such as the production of the daily newsletter and promotional programs on radio and television. The delegates were accorded an opportunity to sample some of Livingstone City's tourist attraction sites. Among the sites visited is the mighty Victoria Falls. Besides the Victoria Falls, delegates also visited interesting places such as the Livingstone Museum, the country's biggest museum dating back to the 1930s. Another site visited was the Musotunya National Park, which is the smallest park in the country. The other combo for the delegates were bungee jumping, the Mukuni Big Five Safari, and the reptile park with large specimens of crocodiles and snakes.
Well, my name is Sam Olenu. I'm from Ghana and I work with the West African Examinations Council. In fact, the conference has been very educative. New ideas, you know, have been shared, and it's going to help us in our work. And in fact, I've enjoyed being in Livingstone, particularly, you know, beholding the one of the seven wonders of the world. It's so beautiful, you know. Livingstone said that it would have been wonderful for angels to behold, and I think that I could be called one of the angels that beheld, you know, this this falls. So thank you very much for having me. Bye.
Thank you so much.
Right.
Delegates were accorded an opportunity to refresh their minds during the cultural night. Each participating nation was given a platform to showcase the worldliness of their tradition and culture by performing a dance.
Ladies and gentlemen, the images you're seeing.
one brave Zambian woman.
Delicate also enjoyed a light moment during the gala. The 2014 conference was closed in style with traditional performances from the local theatre groups in Livingston. The outgoing president of the AEAA, Dr. Joyce Ndalichako of the National Examinations Council of Tanzania, handed over the presidency to Mr. Michael Chilala, director of the Examinations Council of Zambia. Mr. Chilala was given the AEAA charter to be used as a guide during his tenure of office. Meanwhile, the incoming president of the association, Mr. Michael Chilala, gave an acceptance speech in which he said it was an honor to serve as president of the association.
It is an honor for me to be accorded an opportunity to serve in the office of the president of the Association for Educational Assessment in Africa. I know that you've been given a challenge, Mr. P.S. The challenge you've been given is to develop a strategic plan and also to link our operations to the African Union so that at the end of the day, the governments may find it easier to provide support to the different assessment bodies on the continent.
The Secretary of the AEAA Executive Committee delivered the 2014 communique.
Dr. John T. Peary welcomed all the participants to the great city of Livingston and appealed to them to enjoy the Zambian hospitality. The minister stated that Zambia is privileged to host the AEAA conference 3CZ at a time that the country was celebrating the 50 years of political independence, peace and development. Zambia played a role in political emancipation of many countries in the African continent, and again it is time Zambia played a critical role in emancipation of many countries on the African continent from education and assessment systems that were not aligned with the demands of society. He also indicated that while AEAA has a clear purpose and vision, it led a strategic plan and hence urged the ESCO to ensure development of the strategic plan.
The 2014 conference was officially closed by the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Education, Science, Vocational Training and Early Education, Dr. Patrick Nkanza, who thanked the delegates for their deliberations and was glad that they had a good time in Zambia.
Arising from the deliberations, a communique has been developed and which has been read to us. It is my hope, therefore, that the member states will implement the recommendations arising from this conference and thereby improve their assessment systems and practices. I wish to assure all member countries that the government of the Republic of Zambia, through our ministry, the Ministry of Education, Science, Vocational Training and Early Education, and working together with the Council of the Examinations Council of Zambia, will provide all the necessary support and encouragement to the management. I wish to thank all those who have worked tirelessly to organize the conference. I also wish to thank all the organizations and individuals who provided material, financial, and moral support towards the successful hosting of this conference.
After the successful 2014 conference, emphasis has been placed on the commitment to develop relevant assessment systems that would meet the demands of society. It is therefore hoped that most examining boards in Africa and beyond would develop systems and processes to ensure that the quality of teaching and assessment is improved at all levels.